So it's a great pleasure to give a talk so in this seminar. And I'd like to thank Professor S. Lapid and Dmitry Gorevich for this occasion. So I'll be talking about exceptional zeros of twisted triple product of periodic functions. So I'd like to talk about some background. So let E be an elliptic curve. And let lambda SE be some Hasse-Bayes function. So complete function. And it's satisfied by simple functional equation with sign. So this is a complex L function, and I'd like to so speak of its periodic analog. So let's take prime P so that the elliptic curve is ordinary at P. And so ordinary means so it has a unit Hecke eigenvalue. And so when E is ordinary at P, it has a nice periodic L function. It's an analytic function. But on periodic integers, and it also has some functional equation. And it has some interpolation formula which characterizes this analytic function. And for example, its value at central point is on the form. So it related to the central value of the complex L function. And this is so algebraic part of the complex central value. On the other hand, there is some curious factor here. Delta is equal to 2 over 1. So it is 2 if E is good ordinary. So it has good reduction at P. And then, so complex absolute value of Hecke eigenvalue is square root of P. So this factor is non-vanishing. On the other hand, if E is multiplicative, then alpha E is sine. And so if alpha E is equal to 1, so this factor can vanish. This is quite surprising. And Mather, Tate, and Teitelbaum so set forth the following conjecture. So if alpha E is not equal to 1, so in this case, formulate periodic BSD conjecture. Let R be analytic rank of periodic L function. And then this is expected to be equal to the arithmetic rank of the elliptic curve. And the leading term of periodic L function is so as a simple formula similar to the BSD conjecture. But complex regulator is replaced by periodic regulator. N is some conductor of E. And so they also conjectured what happened if so alpha E is equal to 1. So it is 1 if and only if E is split multiplicative. Then, so by this interpolation formula, so the central value of periodic L function is automatically zero. So even if complex central value is non-vanishing, so the periodic L value is vanishing, and this is called exceptional zero. And also, if E is split multiplicative, in this case, so periodic sign is opposite to the complex sign. This is very surprising because so the sign of this functional equation so characterize the structure of so analytic property and it is so and so it also so model so value so structure of so model Bayes group also depends on this sign. So if sign changes, so people wonder how to modify this effect. So this may be the starting point of the major Teitelbaum conjecture. And in this case, so sudden, so Greenberg and Stevens so proved so some simplest case of their conjecture. So they determine first derivative of periodic L function. So in this case, so it is also related to some algebraic part of E. Algebraic part of central value. But some factor appears in this interpolation formula. So this so factor is called L invariant of E. It is defined in the following way. If E has is split multiplicative at E, so it has so periodic uniformization in this form. And E is certain periodic number. And it is known to be transcendental. So if E is so rational elliptic curve, so this fact, this is called the Tate period of E. And L invariant of E is defined as some ratio of periodic logarithm of Tate period and periodic order. This is non vanishing. So today, I'd like to talk about some curve. Twisted F product F function. Let me so talk about construction of twisted triple product L function. Let F be real quadratic field. And or split quadratic algebra. And let's take elliptic curve over Q and elliptic curve over F. And let's consider eight-dimensional Galois representation. It is tensor product of Asai representation of Tate module twisted by Tate module of E. And let's denote MAE be the associated module to this Galois representation, motif of this Galois representation. And this is so L function associated to this eight-dimensional Galois representation. And this has a meromorphic continuation. And functional equation by modularity of A and E, also there is Rankine-Seelberg integral representation. And also, so by Galois integral representation, we know algebraicity of this L function, created by some Dirichlet characters. So this is this is the central value. And period is product of a joint representation of A and or joint representation E. And so complex theory and algebraic theory so established. So I'd like to, so I now consider certain periodic theory. And to define periodic function, so we need certain splitting. Galois representation. Under Pantishkin conditions, so people believe there exists a nice periodic function. So explicitly, so this is so four-dimensional subspace. And here, so tau is generator of Galois group of F, and A is prime above P. And IP are inertial groups. And also, I consider cyclotomic periodic L function. So let's take the ZP extension of Q. So its Galois group is this subgroup of unit of periodic integers. Now, mainly C and I constructed the following so periodic L function. So there are several technical assumptions. So first, P is greater than 3. So the geodic case is pretty so difficult. And also, prime 3 is also so difficult for so I assume P is greater than 3 and A and E of square free conductor for simplicity. And also I assume discriminant of F is divisible by 8. So these are all technical assumptions. is ordinary at P. And A is also ordinary at the prime of P. And then there exists the periodic L function is not given as some Dirichlet series, but as element of your solar module. Satisfying infinitely many interpolation formulas. For finite order, P power conductor Dirichlet characters. So Dirichlet characters define some homomorphism from the Iwasawa ring, and its value, so evaluation of the element, so has the following formula. It to interpolate the algebraic part of the complex central value, and also it involves certain modified factors. And also there is an Archimedean modified factor. So this factor is so very analogous to the previous factor. The analytic L function on periodic integer is defined in this way. So its evaluation of periodic L function at periodic power. Yeah, so this is so periodic power is defined in this way. Actually, so I and Min Lun. Construct not only cyclotomic so periodic L function, but also more variable periodic L function. So cyclotomic variable is so purely analogous to the complex variable. Periodic, so certain periodic L function so has other variable. Called weight variable. So we and we construct three variables: periodic twisted triple product function, Gary's integral representation also works only for balanced, so critical points. It doesn't work for unbalanced critical points. So only in the balanced region, so we constructed three variable periodic function here. So three variable, so it is so one cyclotomic variable and two so parallel weight variable. When F is split quadratic algebra, so we constructed four variable, so split triple product function. So one can construct so four variable twisted triple product function, but it requires Hitter's theory, non-parallel weight. In the split so case, so we need only elliptic Hitter's theory. So in the twisted case, we need Hitter's theory for Hilbert modular forms of. So we use only the Hitter's theory of parallel weight to construct four variables. So more general, so critical function, we need the Hitter's theory of non-parallel weight. This is much more complicated. So I here consider only so
excuse me. Variable. Can you define what is a parallel and non-parallel weight?
So parallel weight means so I consider real quadratic field. So and so elliptic curve over so real quadratic field is associated to Hilbert modular forms of parallel weight too.
Ah, weight 2, 2.
Yes. So,
yeah.
Two parallel weight means so parallel weight for F plus. So weight for Q. Okay.
This counts for two parallel weight. One parallel weight for F and one for Q.
Yes, one parallel weight for F and one parallel weight for Q. In most general case, so Hilbert modular so forms of real quadratic field has two weight variables of parallel weight.
Not and necessarily the same. Parallel weight means that the infinity type is the same.
That's right.
And that can be different from the infinity type for Q, and these are the two weights, K, comma K and L.
So we consider so infinity types say K1, K2, no. So parallel weights so K1, K1, so K2, and non-parallel weights so K1, so say K2 and plus K3.
Ah, okay, good.
So K1, K2 for F and K3 for Q. Totally three weight values.
Yeah, thank you.
I will so be talking about exceptional zeros for this periodic wave function. So assume, so he is not in a, the structure of periodic wave function depends on so inert or split. So in many periodic wave function is considered for split primes in real quadratic field or imaginary quadratic fields. So but in so here I'd like to consider so inert prime. So in this case, modified factor vanishes if and only if E is multiplicative at P. And now, with alpha EB, so you need to have the eigenvalue. E at P, and alpha AB, you need to have the eigenvalue of A at P. And delta is 2 or 1, if A is good, and or one if A is multiplicative. And then, so if E is multiplicative, so then so modified factor has zero and exceptional zero appears, and I consider first derivative of periodic wave function. And it has the following formula. If so, alpha E, but this formula so is not very sufficient because if so, alpha E is equal to alpha A, so this factor is equal to zero. So in this case, the first derivative also vanish. So periodic L function has double exceptional zero, unfortunately. In this case, I can give only conjecture. The second derivative of periodic L function should have the following formula. And this factor coincides with Greenberg's. So L invariant. Several so mathematicians in this field so propose several definitions of L invariants, and their relation are not very clear for me. I exploited Greenberg's one here, and also so I consider only inner to prime. So what happens if P is split in F? So this case, in our situation, so exceptional zero is somewhat local, so in nature. So the formula should be similar. To our previous work for split trip product L function. When F is split quadratic algebra, so in this case, I consider three so elliptic curves, and periodic L function is associated to triplet of these elliptic curves. And in this case, if all elliptic curves are split multiply at P, then so in this case, split triple product function has triple trivial zero. Also, so if E3 is split multiplicative and E1 and E2 are good, and also their unit Hecke eigenvalues coincide, then in this case, the periodic L function has double exceptional zero. So in the split case, the order of exceptional zero is bigger and more difficult. In this case, so we needed only elliptic Hilda series, and we can prove, so we can compute the double or triple, so trivial zeros. So let me see so some sketch of proofs. The proof is, so the prototype of our proof is the one of Greenberg and Stevens. The key ingredients are the three variable L function. And improved L function. We constructed three variables, so periodic L function as I mentioned before, and we also constructed so improved periodic L function. It has less variable, but better, but has better property, analytic properties. They satisfy, so three variable periodic L function, so it extends the cyclotomic one. And second, it satisfies functional equation. And also, restriction of several variable periodic L function is related to the improved periodic L function in the following way. Here, so this function so is some extension of AK, so eigenvalue, and its derivative at zero is related to the L invariant. Say, let's consider some Taylor expansion of three variable periodic L function. And the second, so second, so property, the functional equation is very strong because so the sign, so because of sign, if sign is positive, then periodic L function is even function at the central point. And hence, so Taylor coefficient of odd order must vanish. This is identically zero for odd G. And if, so central periodic sign is minus, so the Taylor coefficient, even Taylor coefficient vanishes. And I consider so minus sign case, then its restriction has the following form. And also by condition three, so first, the first derivative of cyclotomic one is, so because cyclotomic periodic L function is restriction of so three variable periodic L function, so its derivative is obtained by the partial derivative of three variable one. And this is equal to the first Taylor coefficient. And using so this identity, so the first Taylor coefficient can be computed as follows. And improved periodic L function also has interpolation formula. So Interpolation form. So it is delta omega m central complex value. So in this way, the second, the first derivative of periodic function in computing. So it's a little bit difficult to compute. So efficient. However, so its weight derivative can be computed by using so this improved one. And so in this way, so the theorem was proved. And if so you want to compute the second derivative, so to prove the conjecture, so you will need so more relations among Taylor coefficients. So one will need for variable the periodic L. And also, in this case, actually, sign does not change. And we will need also some so square root of periodic square root of periodic L function. So it is called theta element. And this is central, so this is central value of certain, this is related to central values of complex L functions, can be constructed by Itino formula for triple product. And also improved square root. I'd like to give one application of our result. Say so E prime be some another elliptic curve. And let also A be this change. Of this elliptic curve, and then the RSI representation factorizes, and also the eight-dimensional Galois representation factors as follows. This is symmetric square of theta module of E prime. Tensored by the theta module of E. This is six dimensional Galois representation. And this is a quadratic character associated to F of Q. And therefore, complex L function factors mm, And PI grade function also so factors, and I'd like to define so another PI grade function as a ratio of two PI grade functions. So this is an element of quotient ring of certain Iwasawa algebra. And also depends on some choice of periods, complex periods. So here, so the denominator, so periodic L function of elliptic curve is not identically zero by theorem of Lorentz. And so the quadratic twist plays an important role. So by the theorem of Walras-Kruje, there exists some quadratic field such that this twist is non-vanishing. So one can choose F so that so the denominator is non-vanishing. And as a result, so this element has some interpolation formula. And corollary is so exceptional, so zero formula for this periodic L function. So exceptional zero appears so if and only if is split multiplicative. In this case, so the first derivative of the following formula. I can only give some so conjectural formula of second derivative. So is the split multiplicative, and if e prime has is multiplicative, then this factor vanishes and the periodic L function has double trivial, double exceptional zero, and the second derivative will be the following formula. This is certain suitable P. And actually, so I confirm this formula. But if central value is non-vanishing, so by our result, the split, so quadratic algebra. So in this case, so we proved the complete formula for higher derivatives of so cyclotomic periodic wave functions. And I use it to probe so this formula. But it also works so only this character is trivial. So you want to probe this, so if you want to remove this assumption, so we need the previous conjecture. So our work is not very complete. So I finish my talk and thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Yamana. Are there any questions?
Can I maybe ask just to learn what is periodic L function? Whatever you have said, some of it generalizes to modular forms?
Generalization to modular forms. So you mean so higher exceptional zero for not only so in this, so in our formula, so not only for elliptic curve, but also modular forms of higher weight.
No, I'm just wondering, I mean, just to begin the story, the periodic L functions can be defined for higher weight modular forms in the context you are talking about?
Yes.
That's not a problem. So,
periodic function is so constructed for modular forms of higher weight. And they are so, but no, so for example, let me consider so periodic function for elliptic curve, and it's so, for example, elliptic curve for some f, so f is modular of say weight k, and f is so ordinary at p, and k is greater than 2, then no exceptional zero. So modified factor so can't have zero due to so ordinality and Ramanujan hypothesis. And so some people so consider exceptional zero. So if f is non-ordinary, so for example, over-convergent periodic modular forms. I think so. I guess so.
By so ordinary, you mean good ordinary, what is called good ordinary, and by non ordinary, you mean good but not ordinary.
So, ordinary means so ordinary means good ordinary. Or multiplicative here.
Ah, okay.
So, non-ordinary means non-multiplicative. So, and not good ordinary. So both Heke eigenvalue are not periodic units, so unit. And so for example, so local representation is principal series, and so both eigen so values are not p unit.
Mm.
Okay. I guess there's no exceptional zero for ordinary higher weight case. Zero for non-ordinary higher weight case, but it's so much more difficult. So one needs to consider Coleman family.
Sorry, to make this statement that the periodic L function of the triple product has no exceptional zero, it's true, but it...
So no exceptional zero in ordinary higher weight case. I don't check so this rigorously, but I guess so no exceptional zero in this case.
All right. Thank you.
So, it is not difficult to check it. So. This factor, so modified p factor, so is given so very so explicitly, and I can't think.
Okay. So no, okay.
It's so quite a routine. No exceptions.
Any other questions to the speaker? Okay, so if not, let's thank the speaker again. What's our plan for the future, Dima?
Actually, I'm not sure yet, but I really hope to have a seminar in 2 weeks.
Oh, okay. So please be watch for updates, and happy Thanksgiving, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah. And until next time.
Good. Bye, Yaraj.
Bye-bye, Dipendra.
Bye-bye. Very good talk, Yamana. Beautiful. You always speak very clearly. You speak very clearly, always. No, so you are into periodic L functions now.
Yes, so I'm interested currently in the periodic theory.
Okay.
So
it's a very